contrary to most of our other treatments available in psychiatry, for example, medication, instead of changing the biology of a specific neurotransmitter all over the body, using TMS, we can enter into a specific brain area or a specific brain circuit and change its activity in a more selective and specific way. TMS stands for transcranial magnetic stimulation, and it is an approach that allows us to manipulate the activity of focal brain areas in a way that can be used in humans. It's not painful, it's not invasive, it doesn't demand us to do any kind of surgery, so it can be done safely in both in healthy individuals for research purposes and in people that have disorders for treatment and or diagnosis. In the early 2000s, with the accumulation of some academic-based evidence that it could be useful in depression, a large trial was done that demonstrated its efficacy and was used by the FDA to approve its use in treatment-resistant depression. That is, in people that have not responded to a medication in terms of antidepressant response. It seems to be fundamental to induce an electric current in the cortical tissue, right? And that seems to be its primary mechanism of functioning. And through that electric current, it's going to induce neurons to fire. Right? So there are going to be action potentials that are going to be induced by each pulse of TMS. It's much less well known as to the mechanisms why repetitive pulses of TMS, which is what we call RTMS or repetitive transcranial magnetic stimulation, how that is going to induce long-lasting changes in excitability that will continue even after you finish the stimulation proper. What we're interested in trying to understand is how these measures of excitability and how these measures of how the excitability is changed by RTMS, how can they be used to better identify people that have a disorder versus people that don't have a disorder, or maybe discriminate people that have different disorders using an objective measurement of brain function. And on the other hand, using the same kinds of measurements to try to anticipate who will better respond to different treatments, which is something that we currently absolutely do not have in psychiatry, right? So what we do for treatment is trial and error. We try a treatment, if it doesn't work, we go for the next treatment, if that doesn't work, we go for the next treatment, which obviously can be, in some patients, a very tough process. And so if we had instruments that would allow us to understand who would best respond to a treatment before actually applying it, that would be of immense use for patients and for clinicians. Regarding future plans for TMS and RTMS here at the Champalimaud Foundation, some of the future is actually happening already, which is setting up a lab to perform research and to be able to treat patients in a structured clinical TMS program that is available for patients that need it. And that's happening already, and we're very happy as to how it's progressing.